This is an update on the analog journey we embarked on about 2 years ago, and as you will see, things have changed quite a bit here in the control room. A quick recap for anyone who hasn't seen the other videos about the console. About 2 years ago, I found a used Soundtracs M series console here in a local listing. It was sold as is without a power supply, and I had no idea if it would even work. But the price, which was 250 euros, seemed like a good risk to me to have 24 channels of preamps and EQ, plus all the routing possibilities of a board here in the control room. So we bought it, and after finding the schematics slash manual of the console, Jim from SideFX built a power supply from the ground up. The operation was successful, and then began the long, long process of restoring the console. When we first powered it up, we had sound on only 4 channels, thankfully something that had more to do with cleaning it rather than faulty parts. So after 2 to 3 thorough cleanups, a full electrolytic recap, and some rust removal, we had a working analog console, with some quirks though. It has a high-pitched noise in the auxes, which I plan to use as cue mixes, and worst, sometimes a channel could give up in the middle of a recording. It was these problems, alongside with some A-B testing we did, that really made me start to doubt my decision. In the A-B test, there were some minor differences between the preamps of the console and the preamps on the audio interface, but nothing major. So I started to think if it was really worth it to have something in here that clearly needs more work to be reliable while providing me with little sonic benefits. And you can clearly tell by this where this thought ended. I decided to remove the console from the control room, for now at least, and see 2 things. First, if I'm going to miss it, and second, what the impact on our workflow would be. First of all, I love the fact that without the console in the middle, I can hear my studio monitors much, much better. It was something I knew would happen, but the difference is so big that this alone could be a deciding factor. Add to this the fact that the control room is much more comfortable with the small desk I'm using right now, and you can see why I consider this an improvement. Yes, it doesn't look as good for the Instagram photos, but from a practical standpoint, I enjoy working here much more now. Second, I don't think we are ready as a studio to fully incorporate an analog console in a way that makes sense. On the soundtracks, because we used it only for tracking, for example, the faders were just a pot that we used for gain staging, nothing more. So having them add to the size of the console makes no sense for us. If we were mixing through it, it would be a different story, of course. But the way we do things here, I think that an 8 to 16 channel DAW controller would be a better fit. Third, I think that for a studio of this size and at this stage of our development, we should focus more on quality over quantity. There are things much more pressing, like microphones, for example, that for me come before an analog console. Also, as far as outboard gear goes, because I still would love to work with more analog stuff, I am researching the idea of 500 series components, so that I can build one by one higher quality channel strips. Of course, the cost will be much higher overall, but I think it is what makes the most sense for us, both in sound quality as well as the space limitations we have here in the studio. So the console is still here in storage, but as time passes, it becomes less likely it will find its way back in the control room. Overall, it was a great experience and a lesson, I think, on how to approach analog gear in a small studio like this. I already have had some great conversations on the other videos on the console, but I would love to hear from anyone who has maybe gone through the same process, and also maybe your suggestions on 500 series preamps and compressors. Thank you very much for watching, my name is Dalam, and I'll see you in the next one.